Hello everybody, it's Mark Oakley here with another episode of From the Drawing Board, and today, check it out. Just picked up this neat rental. I'm going on a library tour, and it's going to take me all around Nova Scotia. I'm going to be visiting a bunch of libraries to put on workshops, and this is go time right now. I got to get to Amherst. It's a couple hours away, so I'm pushing the schedule a little bit, but my setup time is pretty short. I just have a flippy chart and my stuff, my books and my posters and things, and I hear it's a packed audience. All the spots are full, so that's pretty cool. And I'm hoping to get some pretty cool video along the way, so I'll tell you more about that, but I gotta go, man. I gotta roll. So I'll catch you guys on the road. Cheers. Wow. I apologize, guys. I've had a whole day of amazing experiences, in this part of Nova Scotia, and I just haven't had the opportunity to pull the camera out. I keep thinking, this would be, no, you're on the highway. You know, I can put around driving with the camera in one hand when I'm in Wolfville, but I'm going, no, you know, it's just, I don't think I'm going to take both hands off the wheel when I'm, you know, and be talking to a little device. They say, you know, don't talk on your cell phone. This is pretty much the same thing. So I didn't do that. Plus, I was pounding around, like, at high speeds, you know. The itinerary that I was given to visit libraries took, you've got to get from Wolfville to Amherst, and you've got, here's the driving time in between, and there's your lunch break, etc., etc., except all the driving times are taken right off Google Maps, which is perfectly reasonable. It's exactly what I do, but it's an error when you're actually in the field. You're like, oh, Google Maps did not know there was a truck that was just driving that slowly, and it did not, and Google Maps doesn't know Mark Oakley's not going to go on that highway. He's going to make a mistake and take this side road, which is way slower and has potholes, and then there's that truck, and you're just like, ah! So I got to my first library visit an hour late. Oh, it was so embarrassing, right? So I called ahead, and I was lost. Plus, you're like road drunk because it's like 3 hours of speeding as fast as you can. Because when I did finally find the Trans-Canada Highway, I was just like, spent a lot of time in the passing lane and cursing at people. It's a passing lane! Get out of it, you fool! And you're going, huh. I gotta settle the rage aspect down before I go and talk to a bunch of kids. So you go, it's a passing lane. We're all driving together. It's the flow of life. We'll get there, no problem, right? So I finally did make it in, and we had a great session. It was so good. I've done two libraries, and they've been packed. They've been every spot has been taken, which is cool because I've done like zero promotion. So I guess it's all down to the library staff. Do you feel like being introduced?
Okay.
Okay. Chris, please introduce yourself.
Hi, I'm Chris Thompson. I work at the Cape Breton Regional Library.
And she's been a wonderful, wonderful host. I was asked, hey, Mark, do you like bed and breakfasts or hotels? And I was like, I don't want to do either. I want to stay on couches with librarians, please. And the fellow who was arranging was like, oh, that's amazing. That's going to really stretch our budget. I'm going, eh. So, because this way you get to meet really interesting people. Because honestly, some of the coolest people I've ever met have been librarians. And here's why. You're suddenly in an organization where profit is not the motive. You're not struggling. You're kind of struggling to stay, afloat, but it's not cut through. That's someone else's problem. The patrons who come in, you're not trying to suck a dollar out of them, right?
Everything's free.
You know, and your job. How would you describe what you do as sort of a philosophical approach day to day?
It's a service position, and we try to have fun, and we try to, I'm a program coordinator, so we try to bring all sorts of interesting things to the library to help people learn new things. Yeah,
that's it. That's, I've distilled it a little further myself, where it's like, because that's basically exactly what it is, but going, you're sharing knowledge.
Yes.
You know,
that's,
and
that's the official way.
That's the official, that's the brochure thing.
Lifelong learning.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah. And it's, but it's so true, right? These are, anyway, and they don't just choose people out of school to be a librarian. Like, you've been all over the world. You were in Australia. You were, I mean, you've traveled all across, you've lived in all across Canada.
Yeah. And I'm a biologist by training, and it just you can do anything in a library.
Yeah, it's so and I got to sleep on your fold out couch in the basement, which was, thank goodness, because I was, Nova Scotia's big, man. When you look at the map, you're like, from Wolf, like, I was driving, I was in this position with one arm out for like probably 7 or 8 hours yesterday, with a couple of library visits in between. I was so burned out. So I get it into Sydney, which is the last stop, as far away as you can get them, in Cape Breton, which is sort of this mystical, how would we describe Cape Breton? Is that, that's where all the Celts wound up, right?
Well, yeah, I suppose. Well, it's Unimagi. It's the land of the Mi'kmaq. And it's a wonderland, I think. It's just lovely. It's very scenic, friendly people. It's great.
One of the things that I was told is that there's more magic out here. And they're saying, like, oh, here's one thing that happened. It was when the electric light came, all the women lost the second sight. And I was like, whoa. Because, like, you know, electricity and the waveforms that come off those wires, I don't trust cell phones, which is why I don't carry one. And I was like, I thought that was really interesting. So this sort of intuitive ability to sort of read the future and have sort of a psychic awareness of how other people are feeling. Like, I know a lot of people who can, like, someone will walk into a place and go, ooh, she's pregnant. And they just know, you know, and it's only been a day, you know, like, it's just, that's real, right? But when the electric light came, all the Cape Bretoners lost the second sight. It's like, oh, but it's still like 50 years behind in terms of, like, spiritual degradation in many ways. Like, there's just some, if you talk to anyone in Nova Scotia and you bring up Cape Breton, they go, oh, Cape Bretoners. You know, there's just sort of a robustness. I've been looking forward to getting out here for a long time. Anyway, I can tell we've actually got to do a library session. I've been chatting away here. I just really wanted to do a video so that I didn't not use the camera. Anyways, I'm going to sign off for now. We'll cut this in with something else. You guys have a, I'll talk to you soon. Cheers.
Okay.